over the mountain hills of Wales, flying to Liverpool docks. Born the docks in Liverpool. And they'd come up, and if they couldn't get in because of the searchlights and the shooting at them, they'd turn round and drop their bones on the hills. And we had some dropped not far from us, because we were sitting, mother and me were sitting there one night. Father and my brother was outside, and we said, and all of a sudden, and boom. And mother looked at me across the fireplace and said, bombs. Well, we dived under this big old kitchen table, but they went down the valley. And sometimes they would try for the Eland Valley, you see, because we were on one side of the hill and the Eland Valley was on the other. They tried for that as well, but they never could. First of all, I wanted to join the ranks, the Navy ladies. And because Dad said, oh, no, girl, don't join the ranks. Don't. Why not? Too many fellas all over the place. No. And I think of it. Anyway, I was staying with Jane, my sister at the time. I tell you what, I saw a couple of girls, I said, Land Army girls. I said, no, I could do that. But Father will say no. She should get into Hereford, join and tell him after. But I had a General Milken, you know. They called me there. I was big-headed. And they said, could you do this? Yes. Coming off a farm, could you do that? Yes. Can you milk? Yes. I took the place of a cowman. Yeah, he was in the army. And he'd come home. And he was quite pleased to be in the army. It was easier than milking. They went to join the Land Army, of course, they did not, and they joined. But I used to feel sorry for I didn't go to this hostel very often because I didn't have time. But when I went, there'd be someone in the corner looking sick. You'd have a word with them and they'd start crying, they wanted to go. And I'd say goodbye, but there was a raid last night, and they'd be worried sick about their family. They'd sent me out to this lady. I had another, but I was only there 3 weeks, because I didn't care for the look of her, with her long white hair. She reminded me of her. Oh, I don't know what, so they moved me to Wellington. And she was lovely. One son older than, a daughter and a son older than me, but one the same age, Molly. Oh, she was very nice, Miss Faith. Near to a grasshopper, not very big, but she ruled with a rod of iron in a velvet glove, you know. She would tell me about these fellas. If you go for a fella, there's plenty of boys in the village. You don't want to go after those black and white Americans or Italians or whatever. I never did. I never had enough living time for a start. Anyway, morally of consumption. And she'd got it for years. And in the end, she was used to be in bed. And if I got between milking, you know, and I'd finished, because I used to have to feed the pigs and make pig food and, you know, big tin thing. And if I had a little bit of time, I used to go into Molly, but the missus used to say she'd always want to do my hair, because I'd got long red hair. Well, it wasn't red, it was ginger. And she would sit there, and I'd sit on the bed, and she'd be combing, combing, combing this hair. The missus used to say, "Bill, Wilson, be very careful. You could catch it, you know." I said, "Yeah, yeah, I know. I never did." And then Murray at 23 died. But there you are, see? You know, friends. More so than Mary. Mary was older and married, and she was there. She wasn't such a pleasant person as Murray. Yeah, I remember we had two in the farm with two staircases. And she would stand on these staircases and cry sometimes. But then she would talk and say, you know, that Mother would be better now that she had died. And that was my life.